attacking the goal to our left in the first half, knowing that a win will certainly be enough to take them through to the World Cup finals in Italy next year. A draw might be, but I don't think they'll set their stall out to defend. But that we shall see as the game progresses. Ravelli here is the goalkeeper, Thomas Ravelli for Sweden. And I wonder if he is going to be as busy as Peter Shilton was when England played Poland in Katowice. Shilton very much the England hero on that occasion. And the Poles very unlucky not to have won the match. As it was, England survived to clinch their place in the finals. Sweden are now hoping to do likewise. Hussein to Larsson, the two central defenders in the Swedish side. Roger Leung. The Poles play with so much flair against England, and they'll be hoping to progress from that performance. And hoping to show a little bit more sharpness up front too, the Poles. Although so much was down to the goalkeeping of Peter Schulte. The stadium, as you can see from the empty spaces around the stadium, by no means full. But a lot of Swedish fans here hoping to lift their team through to the finals. This is Tchaikovsky. Kazmarek to Vodovcek. Poland, who've won only one of their group matches so far, and that against Albania, who they still have to play again in the return match, being held to a draw by England was the last draw for them. The last chance they had to go on to the finals was to have won that one and to have beaten Sweden and Albania as well. So their chance is gone, but Sweden very much in the running for a place in the finals. A throw to Sweden. They've come here in confident mood after their 3-1 win then over Albania in their last game. Good turn then by Magnussen. A lot will depend on his partnership up front with Johnny Ekström. Though I say they've come here in good heart, the Swedes, they struggled for a while against Albania, as they had in the away game, and they had to come from behind before eventually winning fairly comfortably. Plenty of determination and urgency being shown by the Swedes in the first 5 minutes. Given away by Wojcicka. Here's Magnussen. Ekström has a lot of pace ahead of him. Vakko had to be quick then, sprinting out to the edge of his area to deny Johnny Ekström. Tadasevic. An English heart skipped a beat in that match with England when the shot from Tadasevic rebounded off the bar in the closing seconds. Jakanowski, number 10 for Poland. Playing, of course, Jakanowski for Celtic in Scotland. Tchaikovsky. A much changed Polish side for the team thrashed by England at Wembley, 3-0 back in June. Joachim Nilsson for Sweden. One of the four players in midfield for Sweden, Joachim Nilsson. Taking the throw, Roger Leung. Rather half-hearted clearance, so a throw to Sweden. Just to recap, if they win this game, they'll be the group winners. Turn Well there, here's Ekström, ran straight into trouble. The throw to Sweden. They certainly aren't prepared to just sit back if the early minutes are any indication. Ingerson, good play by him. Here's Nilsson, looking for Ekström in the middle. It was Kasmarek who headed clear. Wojcicka. Plenty of aggression being shown by the Swedes. Ekström turning well. Narowski. Wojcicka unable to keep the ball in play. Through by Nilsson. Ekström touching it off. Tchaikovsky was in very quickly for Poland. Already there's plenty of fluency and mobility about the Poles as they demonstrated against England. Tchaikovsky with the pass. Gilbert, he's done well here. A chance. Oh, the cross was pulled back too far. Wojcicki. And then Narowski couldn't hit it properly. And the danger is cleared. A bit of a let-off though for the Swedes there. The menacing attack from the Poles. Turn thundering into the tackle. Whistle had already gone for a free kick to Sweden. With 7 minutes gone, they could easily have found themselves a goal behind. Here's the tangle again, Kasmarek, number three for Poland. And Jonas Tern, the Benfica player for Sweden. Tern indeed, one of the rising young stars of Swedish football. Sweden hoping to qualify for the World Cup finals for the first time since 1978. They've come agonizingly close to qualifying on the last two occasions, so they'll be so anxious not to miss out again. Wojcicki. This is Vadovcek. Nilsson though now for Sweden. Ingerson, tall, powerful player. And that was a promising run that was ended somewhat crudely. So a free kick to Sweden. We've started brightly, but could in fact have been a goal down if Poland had taken advantage of a very promising move at the other end. Now, what can the Swedes make of this free kick here? This is Jonas Tern. And Bakko coming all the way up, fisting it clear. And the shot going past him. And I'm sure he was grateful too to see it go past the post. Bakko came charging out to the edge of his area and didn't really fist it far enough away. You'll see there he was totally committed. So both teams with opportunities. No goals so far. We've had 10 minutes of the first half. Cheeky. This is Kasmarek to Vadovcek. Nilsson was in the way. The Swedes, who've drawn 0-0 on both occasions with England in this group. And they beat the Poles by 2-1 in Stockholm. And a very tight affair it was too, with a late goal, thanks to a mistake really by Bako, the Polish goalkeeper. All the goals in that game coming towards the end. Swedes taking the lead, and then Tanasiewicz getting the equaliser for Poland before the winner from Niklas Larsson, who come on as a sub for Sweden. Turn to take the throw. Finding Joachim Nielsen. It's Roland Nielsen with the cross in. And the header down was from Ingerson, but safely out for a goal kick to Poland. Nawrocki. Juba. Busy little player. So is Kozetski, the two long-haired players in the Polish team. Czekanowski. And that's a free kick to Poland. So some defending for the Swedes to do here. Tanasiewicz has shown his prowess from long-range shooting in previous matches. I wonder if he's going to strike one from here or curl in across. Here's Tanasiewicz, and the goalkeeper right behind it as it bobbled up into his grateful arms. Tomasz Rivelli, very experienced goalkeeper, his 68th international cap. He's winning tonight. Juba. Kozetski. Lovely play by him. Now Tanasiewicz. Could be something on here for the Poles. Hooked away. And the break now for Sweden. They've got players up here. Ekström. Whistle's gone. I think for offside. And Poland taking their free kick quickly. And Kozetski has got clear here. Oh, good save by Rivelli. Kozetski had the pace. He was away from his marker, but he couldn't beat Rivelli. His positioning was perfect. And again, a narrow let-off then for the Swedes. And the Polish voice is now being raised around the stadium. They've been rather subdued so far, the Polish supporters, knowing that their own team have no chance of going on to the finals. They're hoping for a morale-boosting win from their team, and Kozetski very nearly slid them into the lead then. Denied by some outstanding goalkeeping by Rivelli. Corner now then to Poland. Tanasiewicz to take the kick. Tanasiewicz now from Neuchâtel in Switzerland. Okay, the Swedes coming out quickly. Enquist. No foul. Yes, it has been given. Referee right on the spot. So it's a free kick to Sweden. Whistles and jeers for the Polish fans, but certainly not the foul from my view. The tackle then from Podolczyk. Nielsen taking the free kick. Larsson trying to send Magnussen on his way. Podolczyk again was the defender involved. Player who's attracting a lot of interest from clubs around Europe, Podolczyk, including Manchester United and Tottenham in England. the moment still with Legia Warsaw. Put on our gone, still Poland 0, Sweden 0. A fairly eventful opening quarter of an hour though. Another free kick to Sweden. This time for a foul on Ekström. Play it now in France with Cam. Of course, made his name with Gothenburg and Bayern Munich. Never quite fulfilled the promise, though, that he had in his earlier years. Johnny Ekström, as the shot was fired over the bar. Marco here, who was discovered by Tomaszewski, the hero of the Polish team back in 74. Indeed, in 73, when they qualified the World Cup finals at England's expense. Tomaszewski, you may remember, making some astonishing saves to keep England out. Well, for the moment, Sweden are keeping Poland out. In the same situation at the other end too. No goals so far. Both teams have had their chances though. It's a free kick here to Poland. Foul on Tadasevich. Domczyk taking the free kick. Kozicki dancing past the challenges. Not a very effective clearance initially from Leung, but the reassuring figure of Glenn Hussein was there to steer the ball back to Ravelli. Ravelli from IFK Gothenburg. Ball coming straight back to him. Just that one important save so far from Ravelli. It could be a crucial one as the night wears on. Magnussen was a strong player to hold off. And the shot wasn't too far wide then. Set up by the challenge from Magnussen. Joubert. Kofsky. Again, his intelligent approach play from the Poles. Tadasevich ran straight into Leung, and in fact left his leg trailing then. Tadasevich kicking off from referee Zilla. And the anguish there on the face of Leung. Good player though, Tadasevich, but he was a little naughty then. So a free kick to Sweden. Leung thankfully is okay and back on his feet again. And Glenn Hussein will take the free kick for Sweden. In search of the front players, Magnussen and Ekström. Another crisp tackle by the Swedes. They're looking to deny the Poles' space. But they are, as I was saying earlier on, a very mobile side, the Poles. Often interchanging positions, hoping to drag, of course, their markers out of position. Leung has done well here, initially anyway. The throw to Sweden. Czekanowski with the tackle. His turn, has he forced the corner? He has. Barco's turn for some organising now. He's a big fella, 6'4", Barco. relative newcomer on the international scene. 8 caps before this game tonight. Here then is the corner. Bako didn't really get it away. Was it handled? Appeals from the Swedish players, and I felt there they had a case. It did look to me as if the ball struck an arm. Well, the referee clearly deciding it wasn't intentional, and the Poles have gone away with it. Bako didn't make a clean catch, and the ball seemed to me anyway to come back off an arm. So disappointment for the Swedes, who feel there they should have had a penalty. Kasparek to Vodovcek. Ran into trouble then, and he's out of position now. But the ball just too long for Johnny Ekström. Tchaikovsky for Poland. They really have found it a problem, the Poles, to score goals in this group. In fact, they've managed only 2 so far. Given away by Magnusson. Off cut the Poles again. Plenty of zest and life about their play, but no foul given. The tackle then on Jekanowski, which we can see again here. And the referee deciding there was no offence committed. That's a foul on Nielsen. Free kick to Sweden. Leung taking the free kick. Turn a long way out. And not really extending Bako. But he had the confidence to try. Very highly rated player with Benfica, Jonas Tern. Mats Magnusson, his Swedish teammate, is also with him at Benfica. Magnusson indeed scored 4 times in a recent league game, so he's been in good form. And the Swedes will be looking to his sharpness today. But it's the Poles on the attack now. Eventually cleared away. His turn. Ingerson lurking here, and they haven't marked him properly at all. And his shot was charged down. Magnusson, again prepared to show his strength. And this time they've kept him out. But the marking was rather slack then from the Poles. Magnusson with half a chance developing. Hours past 2 players, but Bako had come out in time. We're going to take a short break now, but rest assured you'll miss none of the action. Back in a moment. Of this World Cup qualifying match, Poland 0, Sweden 0. We've had now 25 minutes of the first half. And just to underline, it's a game that the Swedes must win to be absolutely certain of going on to the World Cup finals. A draw could well be enough. And in fact, even if they lose, there's still an outside chance. There are so many possibilities, depending on the results from teams in other groups. Holland, West Germany, Romania and Denmark. It's the 2 best runners-up from the 3 4-team groups who will qualify along with the group winners. Sweden at the moment in 2nd place behind England in Group 2. The Poles out of contention. Juba. Came off turn. The Poles under the guidance now then of Andres Strelau, who took over from Lazarek after the defeat by England at Wembley. And it does seem to be moulding a fairly useful side together now. They just need that extra sharpness up front. The Swedes with just about everybody back. Just Ekström and Magnusson were upfield. And the decision goes in Sweden's favour. And I would think the Swedes would be fairly satisfied with the first half an hour. Long, long way out, and no test. For Barco, shot from Enquist, plays for the Malmo club. Enquist, one of the scorers for Sweden in that 3-1 win over Albania. Wojcicki. Dobček. Patient, methodical build-up again from the Poles. But can they find a way to pierce the Swedish defence? The Dobček. A lot stems from his left foot. And it's off Hussein for a throw to Poland. Wojcicki, who was the leading goal scorer in Polish club football last season. The Poles looking to pin the Swedes back. Tarasevich, well, he hit it quite firmly wide of the post, which Ravelli will feel he had covered anyway. Tarasevich really can't strike a ball. It was a tremendous goal that he scored against the Swedes in Stockholm. And don't forget, it was Tarasevich who hit the bar against England too. Peter Shilton finally beaten, with the ball coming back off the crossbar. Wojcicki. Poles successfully switching wings here. Threading a path through the middle too, until Leung came across. And that'll be a corner off Nielsen. Again, some imaginative play from the Poles. But can they find the finishing corner? Tadasevich. Czekanowski felt he was checked then, complaining to the referee, who's not interested in his claims. But he pulled my shirt, ref, says Czekanowski. Magnusson beaten in the air. Czekanowski for Poland. Cut out though by Ingerson. One of the newer faces in the Swedish team. Wojcicki, half an hour gone. It's still Poland 0, Sweden 0. Match that they will decide with a Sweden go on to the World Cup finals in Italy next year. If they win, it certainly will. That will be enough to guarantee their participation. Poles, of course, were there in 86. Rather disappointing, though. They went out in the first phase. They also qualified in 82, 78 and 74. Missing out this time.